Speaking of ambiance, this house second only to my residence. Because the Chinatel is located in front of mangroves. My residence is in the midst of mangroves by the sea. You are welcome to visit them. It's a poet Western program. To prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. And let us open this for a fruitful and grace-filled summer catechetical institute for priests. Let us once again acknowledge our sins and shortcomings and humbly beg the Lord for His mercy and compassion. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have grievously sinned in my thoughts and in my words, what I have done and what I have prayed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who opened wide the gates of the heavenly kingdom, to those reborn of water and the Holy Spirit, pour out on your servants an increase of the grace you have bestowed, that having been purged of all sins, they may lack nothing, that in your kindness you have promised, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Stephen said to the people, the elders, and the scribes, "You stiff-necked people, uncircumcised in heart and ears, you always oppose the Holy Spirit. You are just like your ancestors. Which of the prophets did your ancestors not persecute? They put to death those who foretold the coming of the righteous one, whose betrayers and murderers you have now become. You received the law as transmitted by angels, but you did not observe it." When they heard this, they were infuriated, and they ground their teeth at him. But Stephen, filled with the Holy Spirit, looked up intently to heaven and saw the glory of God and Jesus standing at the right hand of God. And Stephen said, "Behold, I see the heavens open and the Son of Man standing at the right hand of God." But they cried out in a loud voice, covered their ears, and rushed upon him together. They threw him out of the city and began to stone him. The witnesses laid down their cloaks at the feet of a young man named Saul. As they were stoning Stephen, he called out, "Lord Jesus, receive my spirit." Then he fell to his knees and cried out in a loud voice, "Lord, do not hold this sin against them." And when he said this, he fell asleep. Now, Saul was consenting to his execution. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit.
Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit.
Be my rock of refuge, a stronghold to give me safety. You are my rock and my fortress. For your name's sake, you will lead and guide me.
Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit.
Into your hands I commend my spirit. You will redeem me, O Lord, O faithful God. My trust is in the Lord. I will rejoice and be glad of your mercy.
Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit.
Let your face shine upon your servant. Save me in your kindness. You hide them in the shelter of your presence from the bloodiness of men.
Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my
ancestors ate manna in the desert, as it is written, he gave them bread from heaven to eat. So Jesus said to them, Amen, amen, I say to you, it was not Moses who gave the bread from heaven. My Father gives you the true bread from heaven. For the bread of God is that which comes down from heaven and gives life to the world. So they said to Jesus, Sir, give us this bread always. Jesus said to them, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never hunger, and whoever believes in me will never thirst. The Gospel of our salvation.
Of the Philippines, but then Sister Salicia,
we are the Catholics of the Bar of the Vicariate, roughly number 350,000. So we are not very many. Yeah. And this morning, I just came from our meeting of the Central Clergy. It was held in Arosdivita, some 50 kilometers from here. And in our meeting, our catechetical director just reported an evaluation for the school year ending 2016. And I remember in his report, he mentioned that one of the major problems of our catechetical program is lack of catechists in quality and in quantity. It's very difficult to recruit catechists. And easily 90% of our catechists in the vicariate are volunteers. So we lack catechists, especially trained ones. We lack volunteers, and also we lack funds to support the catechetical program. So that's the major problems of our program. And in the Philippines, where our Filipino Catholics are characterized by the same folk religiosity, rituals, religious traditions, like fiestas, devotions, we need really an integrated catechesis to really develop our people in mature Christian faith. I remember Cardinal Bo, the Papa Lady, when he celebrated the opening mass in school, he said that we are devotional Catholic Filipinos. We have plenty of devotion like Santo Niño, Nazareno, but he said devotion is not enough. From devotion, we have to graduate discipleship. We need committed Catholics, not only devotional Catholics. And I think that is the challenge to you, catechetical directors. You have to find ways and means how to really find effective methods of catechizing our people. One time, I met a guy who married somebody from Piling Puerto. He was experimenting on what he said, innovative methods of education. He said that our educational system, present one, is very abstract. We are teaching abstract ideas, and it is very difficult, especially for our youth now, in technological age, to really grasp these ideas. Nag-experiment siya, at ang kanyang intention is to help slow learners to catch up with the fast learners. Kasi when they start kindergarten, yung mga slow learners, at the end, for example, in grade 6 or even high school, they are still the slow learners. Sabi niya, this is a problem we have to address. And he devised some methods which he experimented on our parochial school. And one time, when he taught a class using his innovative methods with many visual aids, he divided the whole class into small groups. Yung style parang, they were like playing with the visual aids. But at the same time, while playing, they were learning. And I do not know whether if we went through the innovative methods, what will happen at the end of the school year.
Kaya lamang, yung aming principal, especially the teachers, they complain no, na nawawala yung kanilang lessons, hindi nila magawa. Because yeah, merong intervention. No, kaya we were not able to really experiment no, for a long time yung kanyang innovative methods. No. My point is, siguro our technical directors or our catechist no, should also think of innovative methods of catechizing no, na magiging effective. No. The other Sunday, Feast of the Divine Mercy, I attended a guest. Now we have a shrine here of the Divine Mercy, some 10 kilometers away only. Saturday, I was able to pass by the parish, and I overheard a veteran catechist and a good one, no, preparing those who will be confirmed on the feast day, giving the pre-sacramental catechesis. So I was thinking that somehow those who will receive confirmation are ready, you know, because they have undergone the sacramental catechesis. Now, when this actual ceremony came, I tried, you know, to ask the confirmandi whether they really know what they were going to receive, especially what grace the Lord will give them in this particular sacrament. And when I asked them, yeah, I got only blank stares. Apparently, they did not really get now the lessons, or they did not really learn the lessons taught to them by the catechists. No? So I was wondering, maybe that the catechists no, lack the proper method, or maybe she did not really teach that student the youth well enough, no? So that they are not really prepared. No? Kaya yun ang ating problema, we teach abstract, no? Abstract ideas, especially regarding the truth of the faith. Kaya we have to find no, devise ways and means na we can teach no, in a way na magagrasp agad ng mga bata. No? No? Kaya siguro yun ang challenge sa atin, no? Find innovative method of catechizing that will be really effective, no? So that yung ating mga, especially our youth, no? They will really understand and especially live their way. I once visited Vietnam to attain a golden jubilee of the sisters, no? Of my sister, D.C. I noticed that every Sunday, you know, the families really devote the whole day practically, you know, to the Lord. You know? After the Mass, they have Sunday school. You know? They went to the classrooms, you know, of the parochial school. Of course, the children are separated from the adults. You know? And then, yeah, they have lessons. No? Kaya ang sa Vietnam, pag sinabi Catholics, no? They are really practicing Catholics. They know their faith. No? Kaya sa Vietnam, ang dami-dami vocations. No? Dami-dami. Because the Catholic families are really mature in faith. Mature dahil sa siguro, na talagang effective yung kanilang catechetical system, catechesis. I also went one time to Ponta Kinabalu. I noticed the same thing, no? After the Mass, no? The Mass goers didn't just go home. They went to their classrooms and they have classes there. No? When I was in a parish in Cavite, yung mga Senegal sisters, they had a different way. No, kasi sabi nila, going to the classrooms no, and teaching the high school students for 40 minutes, yun ang binibigay, once a week, ay walang epekto. No? Kasi they thought of getting the children no, every 3 months no,
they get the children, the students, for whole day, no, one whole day. At dinadala doon sa Paris Hall, meron silang mga games, no? Group dynamics, yan, and of course, instruction. At sabi ng mga DC sisters, and even the students, they appreciated it more. And the sisters found it to be more effective than simply teaching doon sa classrooms. Okay, siguro yun ang mga magandang i-explore natin, no ha? Kasi yung ating traditional way of catechizing apparently is not very effective, no? So, I just throw some ideas sa inyo para medyo mag-isip-isip tayo. Paano nga magagawin natin, no? And we know very well na yung malibin sabihin, our Filipino Catholics are sacramentalized but not evangelized. So we need new innovative methods, effective methods of evangelizing our people. That only the practice of heaven can heal. Jesus, heal all our hunger and thirst.
Jesus, heal all our hunger and thirst.
That the church may strive to bring Christ's love to everyone who is hungry for the bread of life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Jesus, heal our hunger and thirst.
That we may realize that Christ's presence in the Eucharist is a constant call for us to share our lives with those we meet. Let us pray to the Lord.
Jesus, heal our hunger and thirst.
That those who experience hunger and thirst may be satisfied by Jesus, who is our bread. Let us pray to the Lord.
Jesus, heal our hunger and thirst.
That the sick may draw strength from receiving the Eucharist. Let us pray to the Lord.
Jesus, heal our hunger and thirst.
That those nourished in this life by the Eucharist may be raised up on the last day. Let us pray to the Lord.
Jesus, heal our hunger and thirst.
Heavenly Father, you sent your Son from heaven to be our spiritual nourishment and to lead us to you. Grant that through our faith in Jesus, the bread of life, we may be with you always. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May bear fruit in perpetual happiness
through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to love you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Pedro, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Mga kasalanan ng mundo. should enter under my roof, only say the word, and our souls shall be
healed. Thank you.